Now to a developing story out of West Phoenix, where an arson case at a business turned into a double murder investigation. Tonight, a woman arrested in the case allegedly told investigators that she was forced to participate in the crime. But according to detectives, she didn't actually start the fire. So how did investigators link her to the scene? 12 News journalist Jonathan McCall is walking us through the investigation.
Right now, there's still no word on a possible motive behind this horrific scene, but the Maricopa County Sheriff's Office says it was surveillance video that helped them nab Katisha Smith in this scene. They say it was a distinct tattoo on the right side of her neck that helped them identify her.
The fire sparking late Saturday night at J&J Sofa Manufacturing near 59th Avenue in Buckeye. Maricopa County Sheriff's detectives say surveillance video from a business nearby showed Smith and a man driving up to the business in an SUV. The duo getting out when detectives say Smith hands something to the man, who then lights the item and tosses it into the business before driving away. Detectives later finding the bodies of two people inside of that business days apart. The Maricopa County Medical Examiner's Office has yet to identify them, but say that both were alive at the time the fire started. Detectives searching the area for information say they located video from a nearby gas station. Investigators say the video showing the same SUV and same suspects from the arson scene, including Smith, who had a large tattoo on the right side of her neck. Detectives say that Smith going inside of the store, coming out with a drink inside of a glass container. Investigators say she was then seen removing a gas pump and bringing it to the driver's side door. A glass container was found near where the fire started. Using several databases, detectives say they located Smith at an apartment near Greenway Road and I-17. According to detectives, Smith said she was forced to participate in the crime, but didn't answer any other questions.
Smith facing a number of charges, including arson, murder, as well as drug charges connected to this scene. She's currently being held at the Maricopa County Jail on a $1 million bond. But tonight, so many other questions still remain, including exactly who that man that detectives say was with Smith at the time of this incident. We'll be staying in contact with investigators to learn more about him as this case continues to unfold. We're in downtown tonight. Jonathan McCall, 12 News.